The story of the two men, the man who had gardens and he had lots of wealth. And what did he say? We read the meaning of Surah Al-Kahf. It says, he said, all this I have been granted because of my own capacity, my brain. I worked hard and it's not going to be depleted, not at all. So two main things. He related all the wealth he had to himself. That's a mistake. And secondly, he said, this is not going to be depleted. It's going to last forever. مَا أَظُنُّ أَن تَبِيدَ هَذِهِ أَبَدًا I don't think this is ever going to be depleted. Not at all. وَمَا أَظُنُّ السَّاعَةَ قَائِمَةً And I don't think that there is something known as the hour. How can there be an hour where things are going to come to an end when I am enjoying so much here? I've got so much wealth and I've got this and that. And Allahu Akbar, he was given some guidance. That guidance is mentioned in Surah Al-Kahf that, hey, look, for you it's best to say that this is not because of my brain, my capacity. Allah has blessed me. He has guided me in a certain direction. He has allowed me to earn all this. So these earnings are actually from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's got nothing to do with me. I put in a small effort and Allah is the one who provided. That is what we learn from Surah Al-Kahf. When it comes to wealth, that wealth is not mine or yours. It is Allah's. He owns it. Al-malu malullah. The wealth is the wealth of Allah, not mine or yours. We are only custodians of it. How much are we going to use? We are not going to be able to use more than a certain amount. It doesn't mean if you have a lot of wealth, you can now eat 10 times a day. You know, you have the early breakfast, or the very early breakfast, the early breakfast, the late breakfast, the very late breakfast. Then the very early lunch, the early lunch, the late lunch, the very late lunch. Just because you've got wealth, you become sick. No matter who you are, three is normally a maximum. Three good meals a day is normally a maximum. If you've had a good meal, one is enough. And if you want to have really good meals, the maximum is three. I don't know of anyone who can actually, unless they are not absolutely normal, may Allah grant us, inshallah, normal health. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant shifa and cure to all those who are not well. I don't think they could eat more than three times proper meals. But they might have wealth. If we build homes, how many houses are we going to live in? So this is what we need to realize. The wealth, Allah has made you a custodian of it. Just to see, what do you do with this? You need X amount. What are you going to do with the rest of it? Your family members come first. Your relatives, those who cannot afford, even those who can afford, you'd like to make life a little bit easier for them. And thereafter, look around you, see the poor believers, so on. Then look at humanity at large and try and assist even the non-Muslims and so on. It's not wrong at all. In fact, it is encouraged. Really, there are people out there, we share with them something in common, and that is humanity. They are human beings. And this is why the Prophet ﷺ goes even further. He says, after that, we need to consider even the animals. فِي كُلِّ كَبِدٍ رَطْبَةٍ أَجْرٌ There is a reward in quenching the thirst of anything that has a liver. So the wealth and the test of wealth is made mention of in Surah Al-Kahf in a very beautiful way in story form. That Allah says, there was a man, this is what he did, he has blessed a lot of gardens, he thought that this is from myself, and he also thought it's going to last forever, and I am not going to go. And Allah says, that is wrong. A man told him, you're not supposed to have made that statement. No. And he had to rectify that statement of his by saying, no, this is definitely from Allah. لَكِنَّهُ اللَّهُ رَبِّي It is indeed Allah who is my Rabb. فَعَسَى رَبِّي أَن يُؤْتِيَنِ خَيْرًا مِّن جَنَّتِكَ The other man says, I am hoping from my Lord to give me that which is better than your gardens that you have here. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us protection. So it is up to Allah. He can do what He wants. He can take away what He's given us, or He can give us what He has not yet given us. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open the doors of our goodness.